complexes of your transition metal ions. If you look at the board, today I'm going to talk about some color of your solutions. Now look at your complexes which I have written. I have told you that whenever we write something in square brackets, that means we are talking about a complex ion. So my task today for you is to pay attention and see what are the different colors. Nothing in these reactions is new for you. You have seen all these reactions in your AS practical work, but as it is related to your transition elements, so we will be doing them in detail today. So what I have written is, the heading for the topic is ligand exchange reaction. Yesterday, in the previous class, we have studied what is a ligand. Ligand is a species. It can be a molecule or ion which is able to form dative bond with central metal ion, with your transition metal ion. So here you see water is acting as a ligand. OH ion is a ligand. Ammonia is a ligand. Chloride is acting as a ligand. Then your cyanide is acting as a ligand. So if you look at if you look at these reactions, these are all ligand exchange reactions. Means, what do you see when a ligand exchange reaction takes place? This reaction has been given another name, and that name is substitution. It could be ligand exchange or it could be ligand substitution. So one ligand comes in your coordination sphere and one goes out of the coordination sphere. Here you can see we had six water molecules in the coordination sphere which have formed dative bond with your copper. Now you see we have four waters and two hydroxide ions have come in and two water molecules have gone out actually. So when you look at this reaction, it will look a little weird to you. I'll come back to this reaction because here you see ammonia, aqueous ammonia, and here you see OH ions have come in. So I will explain it in a while. Here you see you had two hydroxide ions and four water molecules inside the coordination sphere, but here you see that you have two water molecules still remaining, and out of these four water molecules which have gone out, and you can see a different reaction has taken place. Two OH ions and two water molecules have gone out of the coordination sphere. So when something comes inside and something is being substituted, and it has been substituted in this way that a ligand is coming in and a ligand is going out, the reaction is termed as ligand exchange reaction. So an incoming ligand can substitute a ligand which was already there inside the coordination sphere. This substitution reaction is termed as ligand exchange reaction. Say for example, when we talk about this hexa-aqua copper ion, you all are familiar with the structure. We have done this in the previous class. This is your octahedral complex. It has formed six dative bonds with water. Water is your monodentate ligand. So this is your complex, which is your hexa-aqua copper ion. What is the color of this solution? This solution is your pale blue solution. If you look at this solution, this is your pale blue solution. Okay? So whenever it is a complex ion, you see it is going to be a solution. It is going to be a solution. It is going to be solution, solution, solution. So when you look at your hexa-aqua copper ion, it is going to be your pale blue solution. Now if I do a reaction which you have done in your AS earlier on in your practical work, I have taken 1 cm depth, and say for example I am adding hydroxide ions to it. Hydroxide ions are one of your ligand, and you know what happens is it gives you a precipitate. Now see, a precipitate is formed. Here what I have used only hydroxide ions from sodium hydroxide. Okay, and when we look at the same reaction, but this time I am using aqueous ammonia. I am adding aqueous ammonia. So when you see we are adding aqueous ammonia, what do you see? You see a pale blue precipitate again. So what is written on the board here? That when we have hexa aqua copper to ion and we add aqueous ammonia, a little or few drops of it, this thing is being formed, which is your pale blue precipitate. You can see a precipitate. And when I am going to add excess of ammonia, what happens? So we see a pale blue precipitate and it is precipitate, so it is solid. I am going to add aqueous ammonia in excess now. What do you see? You see it is your pale blue solution. You can see it's deep blue, dark blue solution from pale blue precipitate. What has happened? We have done this reaction now. We have done this reaction now. We had pale blue precipitate from the previous reaction and we have added excess of ammonia and we get this dark blue solution. And when you see this dark blue solution, means the complex ion is being formed. Now you have to compare both the reactions. Here I have added hydroxide ions only. So this reaction was not, when I added sodium hydroxide, it was not a ligand exchange reaction. This was your precipitation reaction because a precipitate was being formed. Okay, but if I just fill it up to full capacity, the precipitate is not going to dissolve in excess of sodium hydroxide. But when I added aqueous ammonia first produced a blue precipitate which dissolved in excess of ammonia and gave me dark blue solution. This indicates that your aqueous ammonia has two species in it. One is hydroxide ion and the other is a ligand, which is your ammonia. Okay, so it is going to, first it is going to form a precipitate, so a precipitation reaction takes place, and then we add excess of ammonia, it produces your dark blue solution of diaqua tetraamine copper 2. Here you see something is missing in this structure, and what was missing here was the charge. This is your cationic complex. There is a positive charge. There is no charge. Minus 2 cancels out with positive 2. Here we have the positive 2. Here minus 2 cancelling out plus 2. So there is no charge. So in the previous classes or in one of the classes you have studied, we have three types of complexes. One is your cationic complex having positive charge. There is going to be anionic complex having negative charge, overall negative charge, and there could be a complex where there is no charge, and such complexes are called neutral complexes. Okay, now what do you see? What was the coordination number here? 6. What is the coordination number here? 4 plus 2, 6. What is the coordination number here? 4 plus 2, 6. What is the coordination number here? It is 6. So whether it is your hexa aqua copper 2 ion, whether it is this complex, this species, or whether it is this species. Okay, so we have to do the shapes of our complexes. So we have the shape of this one in front of you. It's octahedral complex. What is going to be the bond angle? It's going to be 90 degrees. This one is an octahedral complex. Then look at this one. So two water molecules are going to stay and four have been pushed out of the coordination sphere and their position is being taken by your ammonia, which is another ligand. So ammonia through its lone pair present on hydrogen forms four dative bonds here. This is the complex which is formed, and this one is your dark blue solution. Okay, it is still octahedral complex. Now what happens? If I take hexa aqua copper 2 ion, which is your blue colored solution, I am starting from here or I'm starting from there. Okay, in all these reactions I'm using your hexa aqua copper 2 ion as the starting material. So this is a complex which is pale blue in color. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to add concentrated hydrochloric acid to it. Now it is concentrated hydrochloric acid, so I must be using a dropper here. You can see when I add hydrochloric acid, what do you see? What happened? What do you see is a green solution. This is our starting color. Now you can compare. You can compare. This is your hexa aqua copper 2 ion, and this one is your tetrachloro complex. Okay, so we have this complex form, and you can see it is a green color solution. And as you can see, it's a green color solution. This reaction is also representing, it's also representing your ligand exchange reaction. So if I write the nature of the reaction, this reaction was precipitation. There was no ligand exchange, but this was a ligand exchange reaction. This one is a ligand exchange reaction. You have just seen the reaction. The next is also going to be a ligand exchange reaction. So if we are adding a reagent and a precipitate is formed, that formation of a precipitate indicates it's a precipitation reaction. But if it's a solution which is formed, then it is going to be your ligand exchange reaction. But you see what has happened here. When hexa aqua ions were being allowed to react with your chloride ions, chloride is acting as a ligand here, a complex is formed. But this time the complex formed is not an octahedral complex. You can see it's a tetrahedral complex, and all water molecules have been pushed outside coordination sphere. So for this particular case, we have copper 2 positive, and copper 2 positive is forming a tetrahedral complex with chloride ions. Chloride ion has a negative charge as well as it has a lone pair of electrons on it. So this complex ion is formed. This one is your tetrahedral complex. And what is going to be the bond angle? It's going to be 109.5 degree. And here, what is going to be the angle in an octahedral complex? It's going to be 90 degree. So what do you see? What is the difference between the shape? Why there is change in the shape? Why from an octahedral complex, now the new complex which is formed is your tetrahedral complex? So always remember, whenever you have ligands which are bigger in size and they have negative charge on them. So if, say for example, I am going to put a chloride ion here, a chloride ion here, a chloride ion there. Now you see, there are lone pairs and they are bigger in size. So they are present very close to each other. They are going to experience repulsions here. They are going to experience repulsions. So in order to overcome these repulsions, what do? They push these two chloride ions out of the complex, and they attain this tetrahedral shape. So usually change in geometry is observed when you have your ligands which are bigger in size and when they are carrying negative charge on them. But if hydroxide ion is there, the geometry will still be the same octahedral, because hydroxide ion is very small in size and it is not going to take more space, so it is going to form an octahedral complex. So if I have 6 OH ions with iron or any other or like your copper or any other transition metal ion, then the complex is going to be your octahedral. But whenever it's chloride, it's going to be cyanide. So the next reaction which we have to do is same copper two ions, hexa-aqua copper two ion, and I'm going to add cyanide ions to it. Now what do you see? You have to observe. What happens is this color. So a dark color or a purple color solution is formed. Okay, so there you can see we have now, if I'm going to explain the difference, what is this color or what is this one? This is your hexa-aqua copper two ions. When we added hydroxide ions to it, it has formed precipitate. It is a pale blue precipitate. When a lesser amount of ammonia was being added, so we get this blue precipitate. But this is not a ligand exchange reaction. But when you see here, a solution is being formed here. A solution is being formed and you can see a purple color or a deep blue color solution for your diaqua tetraamine, and here you see chloride ion has given you these solutions. Okay, so these are all your ligand exchange reactions. Now when we look at these ligand exchange reaction, one ligand can displace the other one. Now see, we have this one, we have this tetrachloro complex here, which is green in color. Now, if I add water to it, what will happen? All these reactions are actually reversible reactions. So, if I'm adding distilled water to it, what will happen to the color? See, it has turned blue. Now the ligand exchange has been taking place in the opposite direction. Okay, so it has turned pale blue, indicating that now chloride ions have been exchanged or being substituted by water molecules. You can see this, as it is a very light color, you can see blue color on the surface. So when we look at our ligands, ligands have their strength. Like everything has a strength. Some are strong, some are weak, some have medium strength. So I have written this list for you: iodide, bromide, sulfide, thiocyanide, chloride, hydroxide, water, ammonia, cyanide, carbon monoxide. These are all of them are ligands. All of them are used in reactions. We are familiar with some of these ligands. Like we have seen chloride ions. It was forming a green solution. We have seen water, which is acting as a ligand. We have seen hydroxide ions acting as a ligand here. Then we have seen ammonia acting as a ligand. We have seen cyanide acting as a ligand. We all are familiar with carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is also one of the very strong ligands. Well, once it forms a bond, it's going to form a strong bond, and the strength of a ligand is associated with how much of the delta E is being created when your ligand is approaching your central metal ion. Whether it is approaching along the axis or it is approaching in between the axis, it is going to split the d orbitals. So if a strong ligand like carbon monoxide and cyanide is there, they are going to create a big delta E. And when they create big delta E, this is going to result in a ligand to be called a strong ligand. And when your ligands are not able to push or split your d orbitals to a larger extent and delta E created is small, then it is termed as your weak ligands. Okay, so if you look at this one, iodide is comparatively a weaker ligand as compared to your ammonia or cyanide. And that's why you see when a stronger ligand is there, color intensity is going to be greater as well. Okay, so I hope you have understood these reactions. We will be going through some other reactions of other elements like nickel, like iron 3, iron 2, and a similar reaction can be seen, similar type of reactions can be seen. So you must remember your salt analysis, your reactions of cations which you have done in your AS practical work. It will help you in remembering the colors of your solutions, because you have to give the color of solutions in the exam. That's all from me for you today. Inshallah, I'll come up with another video very soon. Thank you very much.